Good afternoon. The Carrick Company, right? So I'm back with another video, and some more. Man United news for you, right? So Erik ten Hag has been doing the press conference ahead of the West Ham game tomorrow, on the last 16 of the FA Cup. Here's what he had to say. Anthony Martial is not available. In other news, water's wet. Luke Shaw and Fred are questions for tomorrow. For me, rest Shaw and Fred, please, because we'll need them for the Liverpool game. Let them have a week and an extra couple of days off. Also, Erik ten Hag said, on any extra celebrations, no, nothing beyond that. Get back to work. Spot on. Erik ten Hag said, let's make myself clear. We didn't win it, Carabao Cup, with 11 players. We did win with the squad. The squad, the whole season is so important. I count on them, and they will be ready. There are great months and great games ahead of us. Erik ten Hag on early defeats. I know from my experience, previous jobs, it takes time before you get into a way of playing. The principles in that time, it's not always right results. When the results were not there, I did not panic, because that is part of the process. Spot on. What an elite manager we have. Spot on. I will admit, I did have some concerns after the Brentford game. No, I didn't want him sacked before you all go off on one. But I sort of had little doubts. But after reading about ten Hag when he went for the run with the players, I thought, interesting. He could be the one. And for me, ironically, it was a Liverpool game at Old Trafford which clicked like that. For me, that was the turning point personally, because had we lost that, I'd dread to think about back in, was it August? It was, because we signed Casemiro, didn't we? Yeah, we signed Casemiro. The club presented him to the fans, and we won 2-1. Yeah, I remember it now. One of our best performances of the season, in my opinion. So yeah, regarding the Carabao Cup, good. I'm glad we won it. Oh, Martin Keown, it's only a League Cup. Would you have said that if Arsenal won it? No. Jog on, Divvy. Absolute div. Piss off. God, bloody bubble burst merchant. God, we can't celebrate winning the trophy. Then people say, oh, they've not won the trophy for so and so years. When we win one, oh, how, look at them, how dare they celebrate a trophy. Get lost, bloody devs. Have I been celebrating the Carabao Cup? You bet I have. Well, not enthusiastically, obviously, but I've been celebrating. People mock the Carabao Cup, but you ask Pep Guardiola and Jose Mourinho what they think of the Carabao Cup. They will say it's been a catalyst for their success. Especially Mourinho, what was it called back then? Shit. The Worthington Cup. Shit. I think it was called Worthington Cup in 2004 or 5. Or whatever it's called back. We'll call it League Cup for argument's sake. Mourinho won the League Cup in 2005. I knew Chelsea won the league that same season, but winning the Carabao Cup or League Cup, whatever it's called back then, it was important. I do generally believe we're onto something with Erik ten Hag. People say, "Oh, you've been here before." For me, I said it yesterday, I'm going to say it now. This feels different. I don't know why, I just feel it's different. We're on to win it here, quite literally. And I want to quickly give Erik ten Hag's coach staff some praise, actually. Mitchell van der Gaag, he's done a good job. For me, he's been an important member of Erik ten Hag's coaching staff. Benny McCarthy, what a striker coach we have. I mean, it does help that he's a winner as well. He won the Champions League. Oh, and it's quite ironic he scored against us as well. Yes, I'm not still of that game, people. I'm not. fucking Costinha, for fuck's sake. But anyway, and scores this loud goal. Now, if VAR was each, well, actually saying that, European VAR, I don't know, but yeah. But, Benny McCarthy, for me, what an appointment by Erik ten Hag that was. And Steve McClaren deserves credit. I mean, people called him Wally in the Bro... Oh, not people, the press media, basically. Called him Broly in the Wally when he was England manager. Thought that's a bit harsh. Disrespecting the treble winner. Yes, I know he's assistant manager back in 99, but... Laugh all you want, but Steve McClaren's been a brilliant, brilliant appointment, in my opinion. Because, I'm sure, was it the... one of the papers said that Erik ten Hag wanted someone... that had, not United DNA, but someone that knew the club. Basically, like with Sir Alex Ferguson and Brian Kidd, when Sir Alex Ferguson appointed Brian Kidd into his coaching staff, kind of thing. And Erik ten Hag's done brilliant. I can't fault him. He's, for me, if I'm going to rate ten Hag's job at the minute, it's a 7 out of 10. If we get top 4, I'll put it up to 8. But at the moment... Let's call it 7.5 out of 7, for argument's sake. But yeah, I'm not surprised Martial's not playing tomorrow. He's bloody injured again. Water's wet. But anyway, I hope Shaw and Fred have a rest. Especially Fred, because he's been playing too many games. Yeah, but only every few... Yeah, and... It's not the point. We've been playing every 3 days for what? For the last over 2 months now, and I've heard some managers, Arteta, sorry, tickly cough, but Mick Arteta, oh, this team, we've been playing too many games. Oh, piss off, you wet wipe. Do you want to swap places with us? Don't you bloody bitch and moan. Oh, we're playing too many games. Oh, piss off, you wet wipe. You know what? Too many games this next season if you're in the bloody Champions League. Then you probably moan. Oh, there's too many games in Champions League. Oh, piss off, you wet wipe. Tapas Pulis. But anyway, I do digress. Right, so you can tweet me at MyDTDFad2022. Subscribe to my channel, The Kirk Fan. Comment below, like the video. Take care. Adios.